my subscribers.
Oh, mommy to the rescue.
Hi everyone. Today I'm going to read Disney's 5-Minute Princess Stories. Today I'm going to read Beauty and the Beast's Sleigh Ride. Long ago, Enchantress cast a spell on a castle. She transformed the handsome young prince into a headless beast and his servants and household objects. Just look at me, grumbled the beast. I've been so cruel, hold in bell. Captive in my castle. How will she ever see me as anything but a monster? Come now, said Mrs. Potts gently. All you have to do is show her what is inside your heart. You must act like a gentleman. Lumiere de candelabrum chimed in, be romantic, come clear and hurt. The most of all, be kind, gentle, and siren. And don't be so grumpy, added Chip and Mrs. Potts' young son. Mrs. Potts gave her son a stern look, but they all knew Chip was right. I have an idea, said the beast, smiling. Why don't I invite Belle to go on a sleigh ride? It just snowed outside, and she might like the fresh air. Perfect, said the Lumiere. A wonderful idea, agreed Mrs. Potts. Very romantic, added Chip. That's enough out of you, Mrs. Potts said to Chip, trying not to smirk. The beast sent Lumiere to extend his invitation. That sounds lovely, said Belle. I've been stuck in this castle far too long. Belle ran down the long staircase and stepped outside. Glimmering white snowflakes fell from the sky. It was a perfect winter day. Just then, the beast pulled up in a glimmering horse-drawn sleigh. How beautiful, exclaimed Belle. The beast smiled as he took her hand and helped her into the sleigh. He didn't mention that he had spent all morning polishing it just for her. Once she was settled, he covered her with a warm blanket. They took off across the powdery snow. Belle laughed happily as the beast glided the sled through the forest path. Soon they came to a clearing in the woods. Before them was a frozen pond. The beast pulled the reins to stop and stopped at the edge of the pond. "This is such a magical place," said Belle. "How did you ever find it?"
"I used to come here long ago," said the beast. "It was one of my favorite places. I wanted to share it with you."
Then the beast took out a picnic basket filled with hot chocolate cookies, bread, and fruit.
Then they had finished their meal. The beast asked Belle if she wanted to ice skate.
"Oh, yes," she replied. "Father and I used to go every winter. I love ice skating."
Soon, Belle was spinning Ophiris across the pond's smooth surface. The beast was less graceful. Hitting a bump on the ice, he lost his balance and trampled the ground. At first, he was angry, but then he saw Belle looking at him, kindly remembering his friend's advice. He smiled as Belle helped him to his feet.
"Everyone falls sometimes," said Belle. It's part of learning." Before long, they were gliding across the ice in arm, enjoying each other's company in the crisp winter air. They grew tired and decided to rest. Just then, a tiny fawn wandered out of the forest.
"Poor thing," said Belle. "She looks scared and hungry," talking to an apple from their picnic basket. Belle showed the beast how to gently feed a young deer.
Soon the sun was setting. It was time to go. As they made their way home, Belle thought about the day she had spent with the beast. There was something different about him. He had shown Belle a kinder, softer side. Perhaps they could be friends after all.
The end. Tomorrow we're going to read Cinderella's Advanced Lesson. See you tomorrow. We love you. Don't forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe.